So previously, we talked about the Luxor's SG37 Max beating the 10K standard pagdating sa specs dahil almost maxed out talaga. But the price is around 19,000, so halos lumalagpas na to dun sa kinoconsider nating budget guitar. Now, LGY managed to pull down the price to 8,200 pero mas stripped off ang specs. So by linear proportion, it looks like kapag below 10K, stripped off na yung specs. And this is very observable dun sa mga nirelease na model since 2023. Pero mababasag na yung trend na yan dahil sa gitarang ito. This is the Clifton Maestro, the price is below 10K and believe it or not, it has stainless steel frets, bone nut, roasted maple neck, Alnico pickups, 2-point tremolo bridge, and a push-pull, pero SSS. Ako si Pax, and let's check out this guitar. Grabe yung opening natin. Our guest guitarist for this video is no other than Keith Dalieva. If he looks familiar, yes, siya yung Shredder finalist sa PGT about 13 years ago. Music major from UP Diliman and the producer slash audio engineer today. Okay, so Clifton Maestro, this is their Stratocaster model. Actually, isang buong line ito, may Telecaster din. But this video will be mainly about their strats. May dalawang models ito, SSS at HSS. So both guitars have a similar spec maliban sa pickup configuration. The body is poplar, this one is called black. May sunburst din, yun yung gamit ni Keith. And this one is the khaki. At meron ding red, yes, this is a Valentine special. So poplar is a flat slash warm type of wood and this is one of the factors kaya mas mura din itong gitarang ito. Madalas nyo makikita yung kahoy na to sa mga budget guitars like Squire. Okay, balik na tayo sa black. So yung neck ng gitarang ito is roasted maple. And let's do the smell check. Amoy pancake. Now, roasted maple is similar to tempering sa glass or steel. Kaya itong neck na ito, on paper, dapat mas stable siya against weather changes. Hindi masyadong magalaw. Satin naman yung finish nito, so smooth siyang gamitin. Now, let's go to the frets. Stainless steel frets na may rounded edges. Dito, hindi na kayo problema na makachempo ng matalim na edges. Now, combine that with the satin neck, you can easily glide up or down sa neck na ito. So not naman tayo, bone daw ito, but it's too white so I think it's possible na synthetic bone nut ito. It's a mix of plastic and bone. So meron siyang toughness ng bone nut and at the same time yung affordability ng plastic. Visual inspection lang naman yung ginawa ko so I might be wrong. Ang importante ay kung maayos ba yung pagkakahiwa ng slots. So make sure na i-request nyo sa Clifton na naka-file ng mabuti dito para hindi mawala sa tono yung gitara. Now when we get to the headstock, regular tuners lang ito, but can we get a kudos sa Clifton for this classy headstock? Effort din gawin ito ah. Okay, now let's go to the bridge. 2-point tremolo bridge na may decent tremolo block. Yun nga lang yung routing, hindi ganun kalinis. Now, going back to our bridge, again, alam nyo namang highly recommended ko parate na mag 2-point trim, lalo na kung mahilig ka sa mga Polifia or Mateo Sasato or Guthrie Govan. 2-point tremolos can trim up or down, but you need to have this setup. I think from the store, nakasagad sila sa body, so i-request nyo na lang. Now let's go to the exciting part at kung ano yung nagpapa-unique sa gitarang ito sa lahat ng mga nirelease last year and even this year. Sa HSS muna tayo, meron na itong push-pull and obviously this will give you a single coil sound sa inyong bridge humbucker. So you can do anything from the cleanest clean to high gain madness. Now, yung interesting dito ay itong dito sa HSS. Ito, bago ito. So, SSS ito pero may push-pull. But what could they possibly split? So, do you remember this bad boy? So, yung isa sa mga paboritong gitara ng owner ng Clifton ay itong GNL Comanche, which is basically the most advanced Strat design ni Leo Fender. This is actually his final original design. So, this guitar has single coils. Yes, it looks weird. Pero meron na tong push-pull. Same dito sa SSS ng Maestro. Dito nila kinuha yung idea. So, kapag nasa may position 1 or 5 kayo, kapag pinull nyo yung tone knob, you will get a bridge and neck combination. This is not common sa mga strats. So with this, you can get venture tones, parang Jazz Master, or the middle position of a Telecaster. Now sa position 2 or 4 naman, when you pull the tone knob, lahat ng pickups activated. And lastly, Alnico pickups din yung nakalagay dito. Hindi ko lang sure kung Alnico 5 or Alnico 3. And for us to get to know the tone of this guitar, let's do a benchmark with an actual Fender Stratocaster. This is an American standard. Both pickups are set to the same pickup height. Kaya tara, let's hear it. So here's the frequency spectrum graph for the neck and bridge pickup. White is Clifton and red is Fender. Okay, let's analyze this. Okay, obviously lower ang output nitong Clifton Maestro. Interestingly, it follows the curve of the Fender. Pero may spike sa may presence region, so banayad lang kayo sa pagtataas ng treble ninyo. And sa neck pickup naman, again, lower pa rin yung output and it still follows the Fender curve. At may similar spike din dun sa may same presence region. Okay, sa performance naman tayo ng gitarang ito kapag ka tinugtog nyo na. With the floated setup, ma-observe nyo talaga yung improved tuning stability because of the 2-point tremolo. Although it's not the best tremolo out there, pero for the price, at least you get a feel of working with this kind of trem. Now, yung isa pang napansin namin ay may konting fret bus yung ibang mga stock models na pinadala sa amin, so make sure na matest nyo sila sa store, nasa Cubao lang naman. And they will give you free full setup when you buy this, so you don't have to worry about it, just remind them to check it. Now, with the noise naman ng gitarang ito, hindi ganun ka-intact yung shielding nito. So that might be something na pwede nyong ipaulit sa ibang mga guitar tech, and also the pickups, you might want to upgrade it to kung nakukulangan kayo dun sa output. So that's the Clifton Maestro Stratocaster HSS and SSS. So the SSS is only 8,500 pesos at itong HSS naman ay 9,000. I think ito na yung lowest price Stratocaster as of February na almost sagad ang specs. Locking tuners na lang yung kulang nito. Links are available in the description below should you decide na ito yung perfect guitar para sa pangangailangan ninyo. At maraming salamat kay Keith Delieva for guesting sa episode nito. It's really amazing to see him play here. Ako si Pax, hanggang sa muli, tugtog lang.